Hello, welcome. We're just waiting for Creation Kit to do its thing. Oh. Good day, everyone says good day. Straight and to the point. Ah, I'm doing pretty good. Oh, Creation Kit just loaded. I've been working on my new house that I bought that I'm going to live in. Moved some stuff there today, and actually have some time now to just sort of relax. Work on Relics of Hyrule, which is what I am doing. Okay, so my goal is to update a few things with how the archive does its thing. And yeah, so what I've done, if you're not already aware, everybody, what I've done is I've reworked the script, the code for the archive displays, so that they. First of all, I got rid of a lot of fluff that was in the script that was unnecessary, and I made it a little more streamlined. Not too streamlined. And now, if you, it has always been that if you have nothing, you go up to it and it says this is how many things are in the display. And then I added if you have the Triforce of Wisdom and Triforce of Knowledge, it tells you what the display is. But now, if you have the Triforce of Wisdom, Triforce of Knowledge, and what I'm calling Nehru's Favor or Nehru's Gratitude. Then it'll tell you what is missing from the display. And Nehru's Favor is going to be part of another rework, of the goddess statues that will actually allow you to pray to one of the goddess statues if you have a Triforce piece. I forget if I actually implemented that. I don't remember. I looks like I did. So if you have, yeah, if you pray to Din and you have the Triforce of Power, yeah, there's Feror, Nehru, Din. Okay, so yeah, it's already in place. So now if you have the Triforce of Power and you go to one of the goddess statues, then you can get Din's favor, and then if you have, get Nehru's favor, that will synergize with the archive. And those favors are as follows. Din's favor, which is basically a shrine blessing. Din's favor regenerates health and fortifies destruction. Feror's favor regenerates stamina and fortifies illusion. And so logically, Nehru's favor regenerates magicka and fortifies restoration for one day. And then Nehru's gratitude is if you return the moon pearl, but in Nehru's place, it's if you reach her shrine, then you just get it. So what I'm doing is because of some of the limitations of the script, and because of the way that it had to be done, They actually last a day. Unlike the vanilla blessings, they end up lasting a day. Instead of 8 hours. So it's a little different from the vanilla blessings. What I had to do, this, here's the script, and this will only make sense to some people. But here's how the script works now. It defines all the different things that it searches for. It used to allow me to search for keywords, but I had to get rid of that because I ran out of room in the script. You can see down here, there's 914 lines of code. Some of those are just empty, like these. But there are 914 lines of code in this archive script. And there actually is a character limit to the scripts. So I ran into that character limit quite a few times when I was writing this script. And so I had to rework a few things. There were some redundant things, some things that weren't needed. But it defines all of these. And it allows me to have more that look for other pieces and pieces that display if the full set is displayed. So that's normal. That's always been there. But something new, and it also looks at, it checks how many displays are active and then totals them. And then something new is these 8 strings. Those are the names of the displays. And then there's now states in the script. Reset, check, display, fill display, and display info. And so the reset check is the default state. So when the box, the little crystal that you activate, when that is added to the cell, when it's attached to the cell, it does all this to the disabled displays. And then when this state is called to, it goes this, which is resetting the location of the item so that it doesn't, if it falls out, I can't prevent that. If it falls out, meh. But this will happen when you activate the crystal. It defines display number and displays active as 0, and then it checks how many are in the display. And then if that number is what it expects, the number of disabled displays, or the number of total displays is the same as the number of enabled displays, then it enables the full set displays, and then it goes to display info. But if it's less, then it goes to fill display, and then fill display is where most of the script is. It checks every single type of item rigorously, and I could have done this differently, but I chose not to because this allows me to see every little thing, and also this is the way it's set up and I can't really change it anymore. It used to look like this down with the form lists, but now it's this, so it looks for the armor that's in display number 8. It enables it if you have it, and if you don't, and that is a check for whether you have Nehru's favor and the Triforce of Wisdom and the Triforce of Knowledge. Then, and it also checks if it's disabled, and if it is something, then it will add that name of that object to the string, and then at the end, it reports all the strings, all the names that are missing. And then it goes to reset check and so forth. This is the display info where you just activate it and it shows you what it is. So it's a lot. So it is definitely a lot. Where is the check? Here's the check for the Triforces. The 2 Nehru Triforces, and then if you have them, then it, this is an SKSE function, get name. It displays a message box that checks the name of the information message box. So I managed to store multiple things in that message box form ID. The name of the display is there and the information. It gets the name of that message and displays that so that you know the name of the display. And then if you have Nehru's favor or Nehru's gratitude, then it sets this variable to 1 and it checks that variable constantly. This is how I made it work. I'm sure there's a more efficient way to do it, but I don't want to rehash this over and over and over. I think this is going to be the last change that I make to this script, because I just really do not want to try to perfect this. I just want it to function. However, there is a character limit, and so I can't make the form lists display a string. I could make it check for the first item in the form list, but the problem is, I'll show you, I would need... That's how many characters I have left. So all those dashes, that's how many characters I have left. That gives me, like, 2. 2 of these, 1 or 2 of these get names. And I'm sure there's a way to do it with loops, but I don't trust while loops. I don't want to run a while loop in this script because it's already so big, and I don't want to run the risk of the script messing up somehow, or if somebody like runs through the archive and activates a bunch of them, I don't want to run the risk of a while loop getting stuck. A while loop could work, and a form list check could work, but I really don't want to bother. I just do not want to bother. I'm sure there's a better way to do this, but the way that it's set up works, and I just don't want to even think about how to optimize this script, because it's garbage. And I have to keep this, like this, all of these variables have to stay exactly the way they are. I don't want to run the risk of changing those and having to redo all 344 displays. and counting, because I haven't even finished the Hall of Memories yet. So what I have to do now is, since I can't check form lists for strings, I can't have a form list report a string. If I had more room in the script, I could. If I reworked it again, I could. But as it is, it's held together by goat cheese and spackle, so I'm not going to bother with that. What I have to do is, every display that uses form lists has to have an armor or something else in there so that it can check that name. Let's see if Redid Leather has it. Yeah, so this one, you can see this one, the Redid Leather, it has form lists that check. Oh, Xavier's late. It has form lists that check, but I have to have these, which is redundant. But that redundancy serves a purpose, because if it looked at this, it can't tell what name that is, because there's no script telling it to do that. But it can look at this and tell the name of that. And that just corresponds with this list anyway. So there's just a little bit of redundancy built in, which never hurt anybody. So what I have to do is go through all the displays that are in the mod, check if they have a form list, and if they have a form list, then give them another item to check the name of. Whew. That's it is a lot, but it works, and that's all I'm looking for. I don't want to run the risk of breaking it. I already broke it a few times. I'm actually shocked that it works the way that it's set up now. So I'm gonna take that. once I'm done with the archive, I'm probably going to make an announcement video that says that I don't want to rehash it and perfect it. I'm going to, like, put decorations in and stuff, but there's no way that I'm going to go back and try to perfect it. Because this has dominated the development of the mod for over a year. And I want to move on to other things. Okay. So, yeah, and obviously I'll expand it as I add new things. I definitely appreciate the offer, but I really do not want any help. Like, I know that it can be optimized, and I appreciate that, but I need to be the one to make this script, and I need to be the one to manage it, because if I don't, then I don't know how it works. The archive is one thing that, like, I really don't want any help with. And I definitely appreciate input, you know, and all that, but the archive is one of those things that I'm just like, I need to have as much control over it as possible, and if somebody else tweaks the script, I don't want to run the risk of not understanding how it works. Yeah, and there's not enough character space for documentation. I've had to tear out some documentation that was already in there because I ran out of room. Formless phantom weapon. Phantom battles. Okay. Battle sword. Oh. Yeah. Also, welcome, RT Kuno. RT Kuno, I get it. Yeah, the archive sort of started as a fan request. And it's sort of like, it was something that I knew was kind of necessary, and so I thought, well, I need to make sure that I have as much, like, creative control over it as possible. And granted, this is my project, I do what I want, but, like, with the archive, I have to know what every single little cog does, or else it's just not going to happen. And once in a while, somebody will suggest to adjust it to be more like... Oh, I already did that one. To be more like Legacy of the Dragonborn, and that hurts my soul. Because it's just like, this is the way it is. Like, it has to be this way. Granted, it doesn't have to be this way, but I can't... there's already stuff from SKSE. The name reporting is from SKSE. And I just, again, like, I don't want to bother. And I don't want to tweak it any more than it needs to tweak. It functions. And that's what I'm going for, is functionality. I already did the Forgotten Staff display. And yeah, if I make it too similar to the Legacy of the Dragonborn, then what's the point of even having it? I understand how popular Legacy of the Dragonborn is, but if I take so much inspiration from Legacy of the Dragonborn, then I would have just been better off making a patch. But I want it to be part of the mod. I don't want it to be a patch. And I don't want it to be Legacy of the Dragonborn. And then, you know, the assumption is Legacy of Dragonborn is the only way to do things, which is not the case. I haven't seen the official patch, or the unofficial, the new unofficial patch for Legacy and Relics. I'm not involved with it, and I have no idea what is all in it. And also, I don't really like Legacy of the Dragonborn that much. I have so much going on just focusing on my mod. I don't really have the wherewithal to keep up with compatibility patches that other people have made. Oh. Well, I haven't taken a look. I might take a peek. I might, when I'm saving, I could take a peek at it, the page, just to get like a brief overview of gut reactions. And yeah, the remaster mod. That sure does exist. Okay. Yeah. They put a lot of work into it. They definitely put a lot of work into it. And I did give them permission. Like, people can do what they want. I'm okay with that, as long as they're not redistributing my assets with, you know, and like my ESP, which is what it originally was. Oh, it was that, no, I have seen that. Yeah, it was the one using the, extra halls of the Legacy, of the museum, the Legacy Museum. I did see that. And I agree that it's a bit overstuffed. There's something to be said for make it more compact. The archive isn't very compact, and that's by design, because I know the mod's going to expand. So the archive is very open, because I know that I'm going to have to fill it in over time. So it looks, that Legacy patch looks nice. And I like that they used so many banners. But it does feel less focused. The archive is more focused. Yeah, more of a... Yeah, that's a good way to put it. It's more like a hoard than a museum. He did this one. It's right there. Forgotten O2, forgotten. Oh no, I'm supposed to do darkness weapons. Darkness dagger. Okay. Darkness sword. Darkness sword key. And then the battle sword. Almost there. We just have a bunch more. People have suggest so something to keep in mind is that Relics of Hyrule is for legendary and special edition. So it has to be something that can be in legendary as well. And there's no fishing creation club content in Legacy, in Legendary Edition. So fishing and fish are very unlikely. I don't think they would add anything to Relics of Hyrule, and it's not really what Relics of Hyrule is about. I'm not particularly interested in adding fish. In fact, I think I'm just gonna double check the idea spreadsheet because I know it's on there. Just want to see if I have put anything. Yeah, fishing will have to be. Oh, jeez. Okay, I'll have to. I'll look at those when I'm saving. There's some new things. Let's look for fish. Yeah, fishing would have to be a patch. Like a community patch, because it's not something I'm particularly interested in. Fish. It's currently very unlikely. Yeah, I don't really want to add fish. But there is a slim chance that when I add the time shift stones, you might be able to find Hylian fish in those areas, but I don't really want to add fish. Like, I don't want anyone to get their hopes up about fish. I might. There's pretty much with all of these responses, there's like percentage chances of things getting into the mod. Confirmation, I mean, yes is like 100% because I already did it. Approved is like 90%. Not interested is like 10% chance of getting in. No is a 0% chance. I might put a little chart somewhere because I like add charts. Goats, no. That's a no. That's pretty much, yeah, that's. I don't want to say no. I'm going to say not interested because everything that I consider has to be reasonable. It has to be something that could add something to the experience. Looking at the rejections, spin attack, what does that add? Oh, aquatic enemies, that's a not interested. One of them as a follower doesn't make sense because they're scientists. Spring-loaded hammer is just silly and redundant because Fuzuro Da. A medal for collecting all the pictographs doesn't really connect. Reaplings, Shadow Crit, you know, these kinds of things don't fit because there's. A play as a link option doesn't make sense. Romani cows, they serve a purpose because that's like world building. The fact that Romani cows and cuckoos can be found in the archive shows sort of hints. That's a hint as to their origin, so that's like lore. And that's useful. But an Orin goat is sort of like a novelty. And not to shoot that idea down, I don't like shooting ideas down. My mind just works very quickly. I might put the idea chart, because there's an idea guidelines chart. I might put another sheet on here, that has that chart on it. I already have these. I should do that. I should put that in here somewhere so that people can see it. There's certain criteria for how ideas can be implemented and what's feasible for the mod. Okay, this one's already good. I think I already did the circlets. I think I did the circlets and the caps and the bombs. I was jumping around. Ah, this one I need to do. Armor, fairy, circlet. Farron circlet. Yeah, it's all about discussion. Like, sometimes an idea, like Kukos are a great example. Kukos were one of those things that people kept requesting. People kept saying, add Kukos, add Kukos, and I got sick of it. And so I said, no, I'm not adding Kukos. And so I put them as a not interested. But then someone came up with a way for Kukos to make sense. Because if you have the original Kukos, the murder chickens, I'm like, no, that doesn't make sense. That's redundant. It doesn't really add anything to the mod. But then someone said, oh, well, I forget how it came about, but somehow an angle came about for how Kukos could make sense in the context of Relics of Hyrule. And I was like, oh. And it ended up working. And there is a reference to their crazed nature. The Kuko egg has frenzy as one of its alchemy effects. So that's a little reference. Frenzy eggs. And yeah, I definitely don't want to discourage people from suggesting ideas because things, not everything fits, but things do fit. It just has to sort of make sense in the context of what I'm doing. And there's some things that I want to add that I will never be able to add. There's some ideas that I've had to reject. It's just a process. I already did the bombs. Let's check out Boko Blend. Boko. 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 Boko Blend. Short sword. Book upon the short sword, book upon the long sword. Or Bokoblin. That's why the on the topic of ideas. The Discord is a great way to discuss ideas. And there's a whole like protocol to ideas because not everything will work. But it's best to discuss it with the community, put the idea out there, and the community can talk over it and see what'll make sense. This mod has been around for a really long time. Yeah. Excellent. Yeah, I'm getting there. I'm hoping by maybe February I can have 6.6.2 out. It's almost done. I have two sectors of the Hall of Memories left, and those take time. I also have to go through all this, but that shouldn't take too long. I'm almost done with the Hall of Prevalence. I have the Hall of Devotion, Life, and Legends. I don't think the Literature will need it. Yeah, Literature is different, so I don't think it'll need it. Oh, crap. I have to rework the Literature script so that it reports the item that's missing. Fortunately, that should be easy. I guess we'll see. I'm gonna write that down. Where the heck did I put it? Yeah, in 2023, August 2023 will be the 10. Oh man. Yeah, that was a while ago if the hookshot was the most recent thing. Yeah, 2023, August 2023 will be the 10th anniversary of the mod, which is absolutely insane. Yeah. Okay. Ashland tunics. I don't think this one will need it. Yeah, that one's already good. Armos might. Might be some stuff in that Armos. That's all good. Armos. Shoot. Yeah, that's Armos ore is already set. Five. Armos shield. Oh. Armor. Shield. Shield. Armor. 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 Also, just so everybody is aware, be careful typing in that word, Armos, into the chat. If for some reason, I think it's a swear word in a different language. So you'll get flagged, I think. And I'll have to jump in and rescue you. 2017. Wow. That was like, that was a while ago. I forget what version that must have been. It must have been like 6.5 or 6.4. You can cook bees in a furnace for some reason. Okay. I mean, the special edition trailer. Man, I need to update that trailer. Let's see here. Oh, maybe that's why Armos. That must be it. It's a derogatory term, so it's like the plural. For the record, I am saying a Zelda term. That's the wrong one. Trailers. Helps I have a hard S when I say that word. Yeah. Yeah, yep, this was June 2017, so it was 6.5. The old 6.5 debacle. Okay, I'm gonna save after I do the rest of these. I think Bub has been around long enough to know the 6.5 debacle. So 6.5. I made 6.5. That was the Wind Waker update. And I was like, this is great. I added all the islands, but something went wrong, and I think I know what it was. But the mod was corrupted. It was corrupted to the point that it was making, if you approached a city, it would make the game crash. So I was like, what the heck? But silly me, I hadn't been making backups properly. For some reason, I had disabled, like, some function for making backups on XEdit. And so I didn't have any backups of the ESP except from April. So I was originally going to release 6.5, I think, in June. And so I had lost, like, 4 months of work. Or 2 months of work. Or something like that. So I lost some months of work. And all I had was the change log and this old ESP from April 2017. And so I'm like, well, fart. And I had to go back through and redo that. I still don't know to this day. I don't know what I've lost. I don't know if there's anything that I implemented that is just gone forever. And I finally fixed it, I think, by August. So that was a nice anniversary present. Armos sword. Good old 6.5. But I think I know what happened. I think I know what happened, and really I'm surprised I didn't have a backup from when I did this. But I think what happened, the Isle of the Deep is one of the forgotten islands that you can visit in Relics of Hyrule. No, that unused arrow and quiver mesh was just something that I had lying around that I just kept forgetting about. That wasn't part of the great horror of 6.5. I think what happened was the Isle of the Deep came from a modder's resource, and when I imported that into the ESP, it corrupted it somehow. For whatever reason. And that's why there's a lot of. I think I got rid of most of them. But in, I think the recipes, there's a lot that's a duplicate because I had to fix it and I ended up duplicating the mod when I fixed the ESP. So that's why a lot of these recipes still say duplicate because I just. You don't see these, so. But, like, I had to go through all of them, every single editor ID had duplicate. So, all of these, everything, all of these, every single one of these are all armors. Everything with an asterisk had duplicate after it. And so I had to go through and delete all those duplicate tags, which is why no one sees the name or the editor ID of this. So I can go back and fix that, but nobody sees these names anyway, so it doesn't matter, which is why I haven't bothered. And yeah, the Isle of the Deep was supposed to be larger. There were supposed to be more cells, more locations. It was supposed to be a world space and everything. But it got corrupted, and so I had to rip some stuff out. Armos. Now I'm paranoid, and I over-enunciate the S. Ugh. Fortunately, context is on my side. Well, it was years ago, it was 4 years ago, so now it's just like a funny, a funny anecdote. Stone Man. I don't remember. Maybe I did, but it doesn't matter at this point whether I did or not. Oh no, halberd. I need the halberd. Happy to be done with this so I don't have to worry about censoring myself. Okay, paddle axe. One more, and then I'll save. This is just the normal ones. Boop. Spear, 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 spear. Great sword, halberd, halberd, halberd. We are saving, ding, and I think what I will do now is respond to these. That isn't intrigued. That is Intrigued. Oh, that's interesting. Didn't know it had a chat. Trollkin is on there. Planting, well, planting, oopsie, planting, we definitely have to be specialized locations or via time plurals, not in standard planters, but you know what? I think this is a likely. These are likely. So, I'll take that and poppity pop those in here. Fizbit. And let's update the charts. I don't need a chart. I don't need to have charts. But I just like having charts. I like charts. So this is 87 now. Copy this for Jan 8. Yeah, I fortunately it's not gonna be as stupid as loot boxes are. There's no micro, well, you might have to pay some rupees to open up one of them gacha seeds. No, it'll just be random. It's not gonna be anything crazy. The wallets that I've implemented are kind of like loot boxes already. And it's not like you're gonna miss out. Ten for... you never know what you're gonna get. Okay. Doot. One of these days, that purple line is gonna pop up. Boo! That purple line is gonna go pa-choo! And then the confirmed line is gonna go bang. So if this thing, which is stagnated forever, I think I'm going to. How's it doing? Still saving? Stonks. Nope. I want to add the next chart. Add the ideas chart. Can you do this for me? I don't want that one. Insert. Page break. Page break. Yes. No. Why you do this? Go on this page. You silly Billy. Silly Billy. Stop being. Where'd it go? Stay. Okay, that's fine. Oh wait, what am I doing? I have the actual document. There it is. Oh yeah, 6.5.29. Heck yeah. If anyone's not already aware, obviously we're in 6.6 now, so 6.5.29 is never gonna happen. But 6.5.29 was an in-joke. It was sort of a, I accidentally, when I was talking about 6.5.21, I accidentally typoed it as 29. And so the joke became that I'm going to add everything that everyone's always wanted, like loot boxes and houses with CBBE support and things like that. Oh, I need to come up with one for this April. My house. I need to do some formatting here. Line, square, bracket, single. Hello. Alright, here's what I'm gonna do. Whenever there's ghosty goodness, solution. Paste it into Notepad and then bring it back out. Because Notepad just gets rid of everything in terms of formatting. Alright, we'll just leave that alone. We need a new table. Table 2 by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. And the max I can do is 20. Oh, hang on. Hold the phone. Okay. Delete column. Yep, Notepad is... Oh yeah, the URL bar will also work. Yeah, Notepad is... I like Notepad. I use it for a lot of things. To tweak the spacing here. Can I do that? I don't want this to be split. I'm gonna There we go. That's better. And actually, I could probably tweak this. I guess I can't. Ugh. Nope, okay, it's not gonna let me do that. I love to see that Google Docs is just as finicky as Word. It's probably because of this down here. This is fine to an extent. It's not what I want it to look like. I would like it to be a little more compact, but there's only so much that I can do. Whatever. Okay. We now have the suggestion guidelines on the ideas chart. And I guess I should put that here. Wait. Update table of contents. Group. Ah! What have you done? There we go. Whew. Okay, that's enough of that. We'll keep that around though, because a lot of, I like this chart. I like charts, but like this just sort of charts how like this visualizes how chaotic relative Hyrule development can be. Like during the summer of 2021, we had all these ideas going. There's a lot of changes, lots of data points in here. Meanwhile, mod didn't update. And then, like, confirmed, it didn't jump up until late August. And then, likely, is creeping up. And so is rejected. And then, poof, there was the great in, like, I don't even know where this is, but late autumn 2021, I was just like, screw them. There's a bunch of ideas that were just like, nope. I just knocked them down. The great purge of maybes, yeah. The great maybe purge of 2021. But, you know, ideas have steadily increased over time, but development has been very slow. There's a total of 230 pending ideas, which means it's not added and it's not rejected. It's just, it's a maybe, a likely, or a confirmed. These are 100%, these are like 0, 10%. I might put that somewhere. Maybe I'll put it down here. Hello, why are you here? What are you? What? Well, why is there an extra page? There's stuff on this page. It's an invisible table. There we go. Okay. There's more invisible table. Let's see if I can. Didn't mean to do that. And wait, what am I doing? Why am I making this? I am just a sucker for tables. No, I don't need to make this table. I was gonna make a table of all the different percentage chances of things getting into the mod. I don't need to do that. That's silly. Okay. Let's get back to this, which is actually progress, not charting my secret code for the different, like, meanings of all the different answers. Okay. Let's move on to the Hall of Devotion, which shouldn't take as long because there's not that much in here. Although there are all these, which I need to name. Okay. First, okay, let's just take it one step at a time. I'll go outset, shield, and all that junk. Okay, that's fine. Seashell sword by the seashore. She sold the seashell. She sold the seashell sword. Okay, that doesn't have any formalists. This might. Yeah, the Hylian shield display will have formalists. Oh, no it doesn't. It do, but it also don't. Thank you, Past J. Calnad, for not doing all of that. This one's the same way. No, I don't. AVG. AVG. For a program that promises to protect me from viruses and pop-ups and all that crap, you're really bad about, like, interfering just like a pop-up, just like a virus would. Like, I appreciate you. I'm glad you're here, but at the same time, leave me alone. Oh my god. Well. I wonder if I can cancel my AVG. I could use that money for something else. I have no idea. I hope ABG is one of the clean ones. I already looked at the blasphemous shields, I'm just gonna double check. joke items. This one shouldn't have any form lists. Once in a while, a joke item suggestion comes down the pipeline, and I always have to say no. We got form lists. Okay. I got Ordin Sword. Okay, I can do the Ordin Shield at least. Shield. Okay. And then the three swords are Ordin Sword. Ordin Sword. Sword Reforged. Nope. Get back here. And Alt. Okay. That's done. Now let's see. What is this? What are you? You're nothing. Okay, why do you exist? And what are you? Are you also nothing? That's already a display. Why are there two of that one? I just need to see if there's like duplicates. That's Hero's glass armor. Ugh! I really don't like that question. I'm guessing February. Maybe. It's so hard to predict. Yeah, it's probably going to be February. No, it's not next week. There's no way I would be able to finish it by next week. Fighters shield display. Fighter sword. There's only one of them. Fighter sword. Shield of Four Souls. Ugh. Armor. Get rope. Yeah, 6.6. I, you know, Definitely looking forward to having that out and about. Been taking a while. Probably gonna make another trailer because it's sort of like a trailer for the archive being complete. And to show off all the new stuff that's in 6.6.2. Yeah, and I like making trailers. Nah. What would be the point of a merged Four Souls shield? I don't know what that would add. The whole point of the Four Souls shields is that there's four of them. So I don't know what it would look like, for one thing. Yeah, I've been meaning to gut all the old images that are on there and update it, but that's gonna come when the mod updates. So, like, all these item appearances are brand new. Most of them are coming in 6.6.2. So, it's gonna have to wait until 6.6.2. But it is something that I've wanted to do. Well, if you want the unified Four Souls shield to be implemented, go through the normal channels, suggest it in the Discord as usual. And then I'll look at it. But I'm gonna tell you, it's not likely. Ah, crossbows. Yeah, I wish it was as easy thinking on the it is impossible for me to tell in text. Like, it's hard to tell the difference between somebody trying to push me and someone like just simply explaining. I was just thinking about the images on the mod page. I have to delete each one by one. I wish I could just select all and delete them, but I have to go through and click each individual one, wait for it delete, click, wait for it to delete, click, wait for it to delete. So it's just time consuming. But I'll get around to doing that once I release the new update. Ganon's swords. Sword of Despair. That's all good. I don't have to do anything with that. Cannon armor this way. Oh, no, no, no. I do not want to delete whatever that is. Yeah, Hilda's armor. I do not want to delete that. And there's no formalist, so I don't have to worry about it. Hilda equipment. Display. This is probably Zelda equipment. Yep, that's Zelda equipment. Any formalists? Yes. We got Zelda's bow, Zelda's sword, and Zelda's scabbard. And that's 3, 4, and 5. Zelda bow. Is good. Yeah, that saves a lot of space, having the arrows and bolts share a texture. Oh, that's Zelda equipment. I already did that one. And who? Green Knight. Mm. The old Green Knight. One of the best kept secrets of Relics of Hyrule. The truth is hidden. Like, you can see there's enough clues that I think you can, like, people can figure it out if you look real closely, really carefully, and you sort of read between the lines who the Green Knight is. And I know in the Discord there was discussion of potentially changing the armor, but it didn't end up on the spreadsheet. So, I really like how that general shape of the helmet. But anyway. Can I change that from here? I always type Dispally. No. I always type Dispally instead of display. Alright, let's look at the sage weapons. I don't think I need to worry about those. Oh. 3. 3 is Sword of the Sages. Yeah, it would make sense for it to be the male mesh. It would have to be green, but also distinct enough to be its own thing. Because it's not hero's armor. It wasn't made for... I almost gave away a little bit there. It's not necessarily the armor of Link. It's not the Hero of Times. It doesn't belong to the Hero of Time. There we go. Now hold up. Why are there two Ganon Oh, they're duplicates. All right, I will have to... Ah, okay, this one... That one doesn't exist, because it's not used by anything. And neither is that one. This one's used by 9 objects. Is this all of it? No, it's not. How is this one used by 9 objects, but the weapons display is used by none? I am confusion. I'll have to look at it in the cell itself. Oh, Twilight. I don't know if there's a... Okay. Oh, wait. I think I know. This... Okay. This is not... That's a reference point. Okay. Ganon display linkage. That's the way to do it. Okay, yeah. Okay, so this is probably the same. 0 objects. So this one. Okay, they're both used by 0 objects. So that's something I'll have to look at in the actual cell to see, like, whether one is a duplicate. This one is actually, like, a linkage. So first I'm going to save. Oh, yeah. Ugh, having 2 lightning bolts. Ugh. Yeah, that wouldn't be good. I hope 3 isn't bad. Ooh. Okay, good. That's good. That's an old picture. That's old too. T Definitely need to go back and get rid of these. But I don't want to delete them until I have something to replace them with. I also want to make it more focused so, like, people can go through and say, okay, yes. Ah, yes, okay, yes. I could replace this one, because we already have a new model for the Master Sword. I have had so much on my plate, I forgot that there even were cube map adjustments to Golden Skull Tula stuff. I don't remember when that came down the pipeline. I don't remember anything about it. Yeah, I totally forgot. I wouldn't mind the Gold Skull Tula tokens looking like they're actually made of gold. I may have already implemented them. Let's look at the change log. No, I guess I didn't. Yeah. Yeah, I don't remember. I would have to look at it again. Alright, this one's not interested. I don't put stock in leaks. I'm not a big fan of speculation. Leaks are great and all, but leaks are never 100%. It's a cool idea having a third Oracle game, and it's cool that it's a cool idea to remake the Oracle games, but I'll believe it when I see it. It's also Nintendo that we're talking about. Like, Nintendo doesn't understand its audience. Like, it doesn't understand the fans. Once in a while, something comes along that is just like, whoa. Nintendo actually. Or what? Nintendo. Like, Super Smash Bros. Super Smash Bros. Is one of the rare things where, like, some Nintendo property listens and thinks about what the fans might want. But even then, like, Nintendo does not understand what the fans want. And they don't really listen. Update these charts because I switched one to here away from here. Oh, now it was 57 to 79. Come on, creation kit. Save. There's only so much I can do while I wait. Normally, I would like tinker with meshes, but I can't focus on anything but archive. And I don't really want to. I don't even know what I would be messing around with. I want to just focus on the archive right now. I could develop. Yeah. Nope. Ah, thank God. Okay. Let's look at the Hall of Life. Oh, there's not that many displays in here. That's good. So there's probably not going to be much of anything. Okay, that one's nothing. Sand crab. Sand crab. Form lists. Tectite. Might have form lists. It does not. No form lists here. Formalists. Fish spawner. He's adding fish. He made a fish spawner. That means he's adding fish. No. It's just normal fish for the Zoras to eat. Half-Life 3 confirmed. Okay. I'll have to test the Hall of Life because it's set up a little bit differently compared to the rest of the halls. This pure survival Minecraft world, right? Absolutely. Write that down. Test Hall of Life. It's a little different, just a little different. No form lists, so it's all good. To a venom? I tell you what, the Hall of Life was a beast, pun intended, to put together. Oh, I need to open the Hall of Life anyway, because I want to add life-size scissor beetles and life-size pestos, and by that I mean they tiny. Ah, okay. What do we have here? 2 and 3. Okay, we don't need. That's already set up. Form lists. 2 and 3. We already have pesto antenna. And everything else, so we're good. Pesto. Perner. I doubt that we have a form list in here. We do not. I highly doubt that there's form lists in the rest of these. Dragon display. List? Magic armor list. Okay, so I'll have to put armor in there. I have Minish Cap on my Wii U. That's a game that I could stream. I should really play it. Since I'm planning a big Minish update, it would be wise for me to get the gist of the game and see if I can draw some inspiration from it. I definitely want to check it out. I have it. Just need to get and play it. is fine. Oh my god, no. Oh, I mean, I don't think I'll be 100%ing it. I saw several hours and I was just like, well, that's not for me. All false. Okay, no form lists. There's a second golden bar point for me. Oh, that's the fairy jar. Fairy jar. Fairy J. Fairy jar display. Chew. Okay. No chew. The dongos! I can't wait to bomb some dongos. Need to add more dongos. Dongo skin. Okay. I wonder what's Ganon's up. So, fans of. I say fans, people who like Legend of Zelda, the CDI kind of memes, I was working on, what the hell is Deku Nuts? Oh, it's 000 Deku Nut. I was working on lore for the the low rule stuff that's coming up. I was working on lore, and the idea with the low rule lore for Relics of Hyrule and how low rule fits into the story, I'm doing something creative with it. And that is, I'll definitely consider a custom Wand of Gamelon model, but it's hard when it's a joke item. But, so with the low rule lore, you'll find the lore books are literally ripped apart, and you have to piece them together page by page to rebuild the book. And even then, it's not complete. You couldn't find all the pages. Some of the pages are damaged. So you can piece together what it was all about. And there's some. It opens with a few references to the CDI Zelda games to sort of lull you into a sense of. False security. I guess if there's one joke item that deserves its own model, it's the Wand of Gamelon. I might use that. I also think I should make sure, if I haven't already, that it can't be destroyed. Because Yeah, Wand of Gammon and Book of Cordai are no longer destructible. What about the Power Sword? Also, welcome. Oh, yeah. Twitch chat looks nice. I could adjust it into a mace thing, but like, I'm okay with the Wand of Gamelon. Maybe that's its superpower, being able to decapitate people, even though it's like, and stab people, even though it's a round ball. I don't want to put that much thought into the Wand of Gamelon. And as for whether the Power Sword's getting an upgrade, it will eventually. But everything, it'll all come in time. I'm also not sure what it'll look like. Yeah, I'm gonna stick with the Wand of Gammon the way it is. After I'll implement the new model. And plus, that's just something funny in the changelog. Wand of Gammon now has a new model. And it does. And it doesn't look like crap. But it still functions like crap. Weak as balls, and it does 1 point of magicka damage, which, who cares? Yep, that's the definitely that's the biggest buff it'll ever get. I might implement that now. A Wand of Gamelon. But still, the Book of Cordai, hands down, is the most powerful item in the mod. Wand of Gamelon, one thing, but the Book of Cordai, that's a force to be reckoned with. Yeah. That's why Alduin destroyed Hyrule. Spoilers. The fact that the Ganondorf, Ganondorf image crashed the program. It's too powerful. Oh my god. That is absolutely hilarious. Oh man. Ganon. I need to make a Ganondorf emoji. Oh my god, I can do that right now. Shoot. Dingleberry. I need to open Discord. I need to make a Ganondorf emoji. for the Discord. This needs to happen. I think I can use the actual texture. I think it's in. Oh, come on, don't do this. Thank you. Books. There it is. Or maybe it's not. Where did I put it? I'll have to look once creation kits open to where the file is. Oh, it might be loose in a root folder. They cause a harm of silly boy. Not in books. Not in textures. Wait until creation kit opens. Or creation kit finishes. I might move it to Triforce, Clutter Triforce books. So it's with all the other ones. Ah, textures, weapons, Hylian. Yeah, that makes sense for that to be there. Yeah, I'm gonna move that. Could be in textures, clutter, Triforce books. Okay. Let's make ourselves an emoji. Emoji. Upload. There we go. All right. If you are a member of the Relics of Hyrule Discord, we now have a Ganondoge emoji. Okay. While we are here, finish the Hall of Life, take a little bit of a break. Accordi. And we're going to change this texture. Why would you do that?
Okay.
Books. Google. It should be just books. Slash. Candoge.png. Boom. That has been changed. And we're going to update that. First, I'm going to go to textures, weapons, and get rid of that thing. Check to see if I already have the Wand of Gamelon. I do not. I checked the shared drive for the Wand of Gamelon. I didn't see it on there. these. They have caused crashes. Let's change this, I think. There we go. There, actual size scissor beetle. Ooh, you know what I could do? Yeah, I just made a scissor, a pesto that will fly around inside this little enclosure kind of thing. Oh, it shouldn't be glowing though. Yeah, I'll have to fix the glow. Actually, you know what? Maybe I'll put it over here. I'll put a static one there, but I'll put real ones over here. But they're not standard critters. Okay, that's no rush. Alright, I'll make another one that's just static. Dingle but Bengal. No, I don't want. Check. Ah, select enable children. That's what I want. Select enable children. What have I selected here? Ah, there we go. That's not right. Should be that. I think what I'll do is I'll do the Hall of Monsters form list check, and then yeah, there's a lot in the Hall of I'll do the Hall of Monsters, and then I'm gonna have to call it a night. But first I'm gonna save, because I don't trust it. We're almost done with that. I still have to make the Hall of Literature test thingy. I have to test the Hall of Life. And I have to do Hall of Memories. Ruptured Sector. As well as the finish the shrine sector. And that's what 6.6.2 is gonna be, is a the Hall of Memories. Plus all this other stuff. That changelog is really, that's a lot. It's also alchemy ingredients that I need to adjust. Creation Kit hasn't crashed, and I don't think it will. There's nothing that will make it crash. Okay. Let's take a look at all of these. Forests. No formless. No formless. Okay. Okay, those are fine, but what does that list even contain in it? Shadow key. Okay. I will put the key Shadow Temple. At some point, these kind of weird requirements, like having a key to display the Greater Chilfos, won't be a factor because I'm going to add more stuff unique to them. But for now. It is what it is. Yeah, those all require keys, and that makes sense for them to require keys. Okay, these require Bokoblin weapons. And at some point, there'll be Bokoblin ingredients. So I won't have to be redundant here. do. The display kind of lies to you because you don't actually need these specific three, but if you find them, that qualifies. Okay, that one's fine. Vampire. No formalists. Window. Gradient. Okay, there's a spell. There's a key. Anything else for two? Ah, the nameless. I think I added ingredients for them. I did. They're just not obtainable yet. They're not finished. But put them in here. So we got blue, green. Blue, green, red. Blue essence. These will be finished for 6.6.2, so I'm not putting something unfinished in here. And then the white one, we'll just have to rely on that. It will overwrite it with the keys. So I'm gonna have to remove those as requirements. Formalists. Okay. Surprised. Yeah, I guess that makes sense. if they're spells. It doesn't matter. Tano will have to get its ingredient at some point. Almost there. Almost. Okay, that's fine. No more mannequin, that one's fine, no formalists there. This one's probably the most fine. It should be. The most tooth. Almost there. No formalists. Okay, he already has it. All right, we're gonna save. I think that is it. Been going for 2 hours and 40 minutes, so I'm gonna call it a night. I just have essentially two more halls left to do the formless changes, and then I can move on. So thanks everybody for watching, and hope to see you next time I get a chance to stream. Yes. Bye-de-bye.